Consolidation. Compressibility, consolidation, and settlement. The property of soil due to which a decrease in volume occurs under compressive forces is known as compressibility of the soil. The compression of soil can occur due to one or more of the following causes. 1. Compression of solid particles and water in the voids. Compression and expulsion of air in the voids. Expulsion of water in the voids. The compression of saturated soil under steady static pressure is known as consolidation. It is entirely due to expulsion of water from the voids. The soil behaves as a saturated sponge. Initial consolidation. When load is applied to a partially saturated soil, a decrease in volume occurs due to expulsion and compression of air in the voids. A small decrease in the volume also occurs due to compression of solid particles. Primary consolidation. After initial consolidation, further reduction in the volume occurs due to expulsion of water from voids when the saturated soil is subjected to pressure. Initially, all the applied pressure is taken by water. A hydraulic gradient develops and the water starts flowing out and decrease in volume occurs. The decrease depends upon the permeability of soil and therefore it is time dependent. This reduction in volume is called as primary consolidation. The secondary consolidation. The reduction in volume continues at a very slow rate even after excess hydrostatic pressure developed by the applied pressure is fully dissipated. And the primary consolidation, the additional reduction in volume is called as secondary consolidation. Terjaghi theory of one-dimensional consolidation. The theory is based on the following assumptions. The soil is homogeneous and isotropic. The soil is fully saturated. The solid particles and water in the voids are incompressible. Consolidation occurs due to expulsion of water from the voids only. Darcy's law is valid and throughout the consolidation process. The time lag in consolidation is due to low permeability of the soil. Soil is laterally confined and consolidation takes place only in axial direction. The spring analogy Terjaghi demonstrated the mechanics of consolidation by piston and a spring analogy. A saturated soil mass taken in a container consists of soil particles forming the skeleton of soil mass and the voids filled with water as shown. The skeleton formed of the soil particles can be assumed to be replaced by a number of springs and the water filling voids and soil mass by the water filling the cylinder. The compressive stress is caused by load applied on the piston placed on the top of the spring and with which the unit is controlled drainage water from out the cylinder. So Z0 be the length of spring and the pressure of say 10 unit slats, the length decreases to Z. When the pressure is increased, say for 2 units in spring, with the piston is shown placed on the container filled with water, the valve is open but no drainage takes place as the entire pressure of 10 units is borne by the springs and the pressure in the water is zero. Consolidation test assumption. Load distribution is uniform. Test distribution is same. Lateral deformation is zero. The area of the sample section unchangeable. Solid soil uncompressible. The test is conducted on a 100 mm thick soil sample, and this is given that excess pore water pressure at time t is measured, how this is, and delta z if it is decreases this, and the time, if the time lag is 0 to 240, it's given. H0 is the height of the soil in mm, delta z is change in the height in mm, and delta u is the change in excess pore water pressure in the kPa. That's how it is. A test is conducted on a consolidation. Voids ratio and settlement changes under a constant load. The initial of soil is where E0 is the initial void ratio. Any change in the volume of soil is equal to change in the voids ratio. We can calculate the volumetric strain from the change in the voids ratio. EP is equal to delta V by V, whereas delta E, that is equal to delta E by 1 plus E. Since for one dimensional consolidation, we can write the relationship between settlement and the change in the void ratio because area is constant. So delta Z by H0 is equal to delta E by 1 plus E. So H0 is the initial height of the soil. We can rewrite change in the or settlement or change in the height. Delta Z is equal to H0 into delta E by 1 plus E. Compression coefficient or AV. AV is equal to E1 minus E2 by P2 minus P1 or minus DE by DP. That is change in the voids ratio per pressure, unit pressure, that is K Pascal to the power of minus 4 will give you the compression coefficient. Compression index CC, that is equal to the change in voids ratio divided by the change in the log pressure, that it is given by CC, coefficient of compression index. It is a compression index is used in calculating the settlement of the foundations. Only compression in vertical and deformation due to void volume decrease. The definition, and it is given, this is AV is equal to E0 minus E1 by delta P, that is known as, and MV is equal to, it is given by MV is equal to AV by 1 plus E0, coefficient of volume compressibility.